Hey guys, I'm Prithviraj from PR75K, and in this video I'm going to discuss certain techniques regarding food photography. So in this video I'll talk about some creative ways by which you can photograph food. So in this video I'll be mixing up photography techniques like food levitation, food breakdowns, or maybe creating some awesome cinemagraphs. So I hope you'll enjoy this video, and if you do, then please hit the subscribe button for more such videos like this. And if you want to get in touch with me or you want me to make a video on certain topics, then DM me on Instagram and I'll get back to you. And without any further ado, let's get started. This noise inside some death thing, it's only one more day. So the first technique I want to discuss is food levitation. So this is simply nothing but just a simple work of Photoshop. And one more thing, if you don't know Photoshop, then a Photoshop basic tutorial is coming soon on my channel. So here's another reason why you should subscribe to my channel. So please. So first thing I did to take this photo was ordered some french fries, because I'm a really bad cook, so I don't even try. So what I basically did was took some french fries in a plate, then I just attached the two forks using some grill sticks or something, anything stick kind of thing which you can just pass through it and it won't show up in the camera. For example, you can use certain needles which are long enough, or maybe just use a chopstick if you have one. So I just took a rubber band and just tied it up with the fork. You can even use tape for this purpose or anything else which suits you the most. So what I basically did was place the french fries in the plate. So after that, without changing anything in the background, I just used a self primer and just placed the fork somewhere in the air and just took a shot like that. And I just repeated this process with the other fork as well. Now let's go to Photoshop and let's do the rest of the job. So firstly, open the image where it's just the french fries in the plate. Then I opened the photo where I had one of the forks. So I just cropped it using the lasso tool. You can use the quick selection tool or anything you want, or the pen tool or whatever it suits you. Then I just took the patch tool and just got rid of the part of the rubber band. After that, I just did some basic color corrections and other stuff in Adobe Lightroom, and here's the final result. So as you saw, it was quite easy, the food levitation technique, and this time let's just go a step ahead and fuse food breakdown and food levitation together. So for this one, I just ordered a burger. I shouldn't have made this video. I should have just ate what my mom made for me, cause I'm broke as fuck. So I just took two chairs and tied an aluminium wire so that I can make a base or something like that. So you can get the aluminium wire in any kind of hardware store or somewhere, you can just find it out. So these are very cheap, so you don't have to bother much about the price. So I just tied them and just broke the burger down and just placed the bottom bun first, then the chicken patty and the onions and the top bun, and just clicked a photo every time I placed it. Then I also took a photo after removing everything like the wires and all. So once again, open Photoshop, and this time you can just crop out the buns and the chicken patty and the onion separately and then place it on your sample image. Since my image had reflections, I had to keep that in mind as well, because my table was made of granite and it was reflective. So I just placed them in such a way as if someone is breaking them down, and this is kind of a breakdown photograph. I just fused food levitation with breakdown, so this kind of looks cool and you can try them out in your photos, and they're very good for Instagram, and I'm sure you'll get a lot of likes, unlike my photos on Instagram. And the last technique is just to create a cinemagraph. So I have a dedicated video on that, so you can click the I button just right now if you want to get into more of the details of this process. So for this one, you'd need a video editor. I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro. So if you're a Premiere Pro user, then you can follow along. So for this shot, I ordered some pancakes. I seriously shouldn't have made this video. So I had something in mind where I was just putting some honey on the pancake and want to create a cinemagraph of the honey falling down on the pancake. So for this technique, you just need to record the sequence instead of taking photos like the previous settings. So firstly, I started the record on my camera, and then simply I went to the pancakes and just simply dripped the honey on it. And that's it, we are pretty much done over here, and let's go to the post-processing part of this video. Firstly, find a frame which you are happy with and then just freeze the frame over there, and then just create a mask masking out the honey part. And you can just loop this video by repeating the clips again and again. Like I said, I've made an in-depth tutorial on this where I go very slowly on what you have to do and all the settings you should keep in mind. So you can just click the I button and click that video, or else I'll also leave the link of the video in the description as well, so check them out. And when you see the final result, it just looks so cool because nothing else is moving other than the honey dripping. Although we don't have any such after effect even when the honey is dripping, so that's kind of cool, and you can post them on Instagram. You might have seen this kind of cinematographs in many such places. One more creative way I just wanted to talk about is that you can create stop motions as well. So I have created this one few days back, so have a look. So I just took a few cans and made this stop motion footage, so you can use this technique as well, just some creative ways. This might be just another creative way in which you can drive your audience into your Instagram if you're a food blogger. And simply just don't limit your creativity. It might not be that everyone does this, but if you do it, you're doing something unique which not many food bloggers do at the moment. I know many of them are this, but still I just wanted to make a video on food photography, and I just didn't want to show you how to take that basic photos, like have good lighting, have a good background. I just didn't want to talk about those. So I just discussed some creative kind of photos you can do to get some creative results. So I hope you like them. And if you want to create some stop motions like this, then you can again click the I button. I made an in-depth video on that. In that video, I explained step by step on how you can take the photos and make them into a video format and create a stop motion footage like that. So check that out as well. I'll also leave a link in the description. So if this video helps, then please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos like this. And also check my previous videos out, because many such videos you might be finding useful. So you can consider that, and also follow me on Instagram, because I don't get likes. So I'm sure you can help me in that. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Till then, hasta la vista.